In this video, we will understand about residue of a function. So let us start with the type 1, which is simple pole. Now first, I will make sure you understand this pole concept. If you have a function f of z, now this function can be numerator by denominator format. If you put numerator is equal to 0, you will get zeros of the function. If you put denominator is equal to 0, you will get poles of the function. Now here we have two types of pole. One is the simple pole and other is the repeated pole. In the simple pole, the value of n is equal to 1, but in the repeated pole, the value of n is greater than 1. Now what is n is equal to 1, what is n greater than 1? This might be a question mark for you. Let us understand this by an example. So example number 1 is f of z is equal to z square upon z minus 1 the whole square into z plus 2. Find the residue at point z is equal to minus 2. Now this is a very simple question based on residue. Now why it is simple, I will tell you. First of all, you have to equate your denominator is equal to 0 so that you get the poles of this function. So now you can say that pole is at z is equal to 1, 1, because the highest power of z here is 2. So z minus 1 the whole square is equal to 0 basically means that z is equal to 1, 1. And then you have z plus 2 is equal to 0. This means that z is equal to minus 2. Now this pole is the simple pole because the order of z is 1 here. But this pole is repeated pole because this value 1 is repeated twice. The value of n here is 2 and the value of n here is 1 because it is repeated only once. There is no twice or thrice, okay? So z is equal to minus 2 is a simple pole, z is equal to 1, 1 is repeated pole. But they are asking us in this question, you have to find the residue at point z is equal to minus 2. So this is type 1 because they are telling us to find the residue at simple pole. Now we will understand how to find the residue. So to find the residue for the simple pole, the formula is simple. Residue is equal to limit z tends to z0. Now this z0 here is the pole. Z minus z0 into f of z. Simple. Now let's apply this formula. Limit z tends to minus 2 because z0 here is minus 2. So limit z tends to minus 2, z plus 2 because this is z minus of minus 2. So z plus 2 into f of z. Substitute the value of f of z and do the simplification. So after substitution, I am getting the function as z plus 2 got cancelled. Now substitute the value here. So the answer is 4 by minus 3 the whole square. The answer would be 4 by 9. Now we will see the second problem. The second problem is similar to the problem number 1 because it is based on simple pole. F of z is equal to sine pi z upon z minus 1 the whole square into z minus 2. Find the residue at pole z is equal to 2. Now you have to check whether this pole is simple pole or it is repeated pole. Check how to check whether this pole is simple or repeated. Just put denominator is equal to 0. When you put denominator is equal to 0, you can note that here the pole is repeated, but at point 2 the pole is simple, it is not repeated. So z is equal to 2 is a simple pole. Now use the formula of simple pole. Residue of f of z at z is equal to 2 is limit z tends to z0, z minus z0 into f of z. Substitute the value of f of z and you will get the answer after cancellation. The answer is limit z tends to 2 sine pi z upon z minus 1 the whole square. Put the value of z. So it is sine 2 pi upon 2 minus 1 the whole square. So the answer is what? Answer is 0 because sine 2 pi the value is 0. So now we will see the type 2, which is repeated pole. For the repeated pole, the formula you have to use is this: residue of a function for repeated pole, it is equal to 1 by m minus 1 factorial limit z tends to z0 t raised to m minus 1 upon d z raised to m minus 1 into z minus z0 the whole raised to m into f of z. The m here is the order, how many times the pole is repeated, that is what the letter m is. Then you have z0, this basically means the pole, the value of the pole, and this is the differentiation you have to take m minus 1 times. And this is the respective function z minus z0 raised to m into f of z. Now let us see the example of repeated pole. So the question number 1 is f of z is equal to z square upon z minus 1 the whole square into z plus 2. Find the residue at point z is equal to 1. So the first task you have to perform is to check whether this pole is simple pole or this pole is repeated. How to check that? Put denominator is equal to 0. Now you have to look at this part, because if you equate z minus 1 the whole square is equal to 0, you are getting z is equal to 1, 1. This means that this pole is repeated twice, so the order is 2. So m is equal to 2 and the value of z naught is 1. Substitute these values in this formula and then you will get the residue of the function at point z is equal to 1. So now we can see the substitution: 1 by 2 minus 1 factorial, limit z tends to 1, d raised to 2 minus 1 upon dz raised to 2 minus 1, z minus 1 the whole square into this f of z. Now this value got cancelled. Now you have to take the differentiation of this function, which is z square upon z plus 2. So now we have to take the differentiation of this function, but here there is a little bit trickiness, because the function is u by v. You should know the differentiation of u by v. It is v into differentiation of u minus u into differentiation of v upon v square. Perform the operation, you will get z plus 2 into 2z minus z square into 1 upon v square, which is z plus 2 the whole square. Now put the value of z, which is z is equal to 1, and you will get your final answer. The answer is 5/9. So let us understand this concept by one more example. This is example number 2. F of z is equal to z into e raised to z upon z minus a the whole power 3. Now what you have to do here, there is not a specific question like find residue at some point. Okay, find residue at some point. There is no such thing. So you have to find first pole. So the first task is to find the pole. How to find the pole? Denominator is equal to 0. So z minus a the whole power 3 is equal to 0. This means that z is equal to a, which is repeated thrice. So the order is 3. Now the second task is to find the residue. And now you have to check whether the pole is simple or repeated. The answer is repeated. So residue for the repeated pole. Now how to find the residue? You already know. You have seen my previous slide, which was about the residue for the repeated pole. Use the same formula. The answer here would be limit z tends to z naught, which is limit z tends to a, 1 by 3 minus 1 factorial, d raised to 3 minus 1 upon dz raised to 3 minus 1, and z minus z naught the whole power n into f of z. Now again, this term got cancelled. You have differentiation of u into v function. So now we have to take differentiation of this u dot v function twice. So first we'll do the differentiation of uv, which is u into differentiation of v plus v into differentiation of u. Simple. So let us take u is z and v is e raised to z. So u into differentiation of v plus v, that is e raised to z, into differentiation of u, means differentiation of z, which is 1. Again you have to take the differentiation, because the differentiation order here is 2 times. So once we have completed, now we have to take the differentiation again. So differentiation of uv again, here in this part, take the differentiation. The answer is z into e raised to z plus e raised to z plus e raised to z. Now put the value of z is equal to a. The final answer is half into a into e raised to a plus 2 times e raised to a. So I hope you got all the concept of simple pole and repeated pole in the residue theorem. So meet you in the next video, where I will give you some technique how to solve this question very fast.
So friends, agar aapko meri video pasand aa rahi ho, then do like this video, share with your friends and subscribe to my YouTube channel. To milte hain agli video mein. Till then, take care. This is Shrenik Jain. Peace out.